Today I will tell you how to find the malfunction of a flue-type water heater that appears to be working. The Nova water heater worked for just 5 years, and now it doesn't want to work. We turn on the circuit breaker, the indicator light is not working yet, and the temperature is not rising. First of all, we need to make sure that electricity is supplied to the water heater. For this, we will need a regular tester or a screwdriver probe, which every homeowner has. First, we open the protective cover that covers the lower part. To do this, we unscrew a regular screw. However, in many water heaters, it is removed differently. We remove the protective cover. It will slightly close its entire groove. Before us are the main components of the water heater. This is the thermal switch with a temperature regulator and the main wires. Here is the indicator light for the operation of the water heater and the main bolts for securing the heating element. A drop of water has appeared here. Perhaps there is a leak somewhere. We check the voltage. In some wires with blue and brown, we turn on the circuit breaker, take the tester, and switch it to the AC voltage testing mode of 750 volts. Using the tester probes, we check the voltage by bringing one probe to the brown wire and the other to the blue. And we look at the tester. The tester shows that voltage is being supplied. So, we need to look for the cause further. To do this, it is necessary to turn off the power circuit breaker or unplug the socket and proceed to remove the thermal switch, the thermostat, which is located inside the water heater. We disconnect the indicator light from it. We gently pull down the connector and remove the thermal switch from its connector, leaving only the terminals of the heating element. Here is the thermal switch itself. After this, it is necessary to check the heating element of the water heater to ensure that it has not burned out. For this test, we switch to the resistance check mode and connect these tester leads to the heating element. There is one terminal here, we insert it here, and the second one, and let's look at the tester. The tester should show a specific number or zeros. If it shows one, then the terminal is burnt out. To check the thermostat, you need to unscrew two bolts and disconnect the power supply wires. Now, you can proceed to check the temperature switch. Connect one probe of the tester to the input voltage of one of the wires and measure the resistance in parallel at the output to the heating element. There is no reaction. I connect the two wires and zero appears. There should be zero here as well. This means the hermetic seal is not working. When removing the cover, it is necessary to immediately check the tightening of the heating element nuts, because if they loosen, there will be a leak around the perimeter, and water may also get into this thermostat, which is the weak link here, but it is noticeable that they are slightly loosened for some reason. It's better to tighten them to avoid any leaks again. I would like to draw your attention to the fact that the new thermostat should have the same amperage as the old one. At the same time, you can find the thermostat itself under heavy load. My thermostat has an amperage of 16 amps and has one advantage, which is a protection button that will prevent it from burning out in case water gets into the housing or during voltage fluctuations. Now let's check the operation of the new thermostat. To do this, we will connect one probe to the input, the other to the output, and check the resistance. There it is. So this thermostat is fixed. We do the same with the other two contacts. Now we can install the new thermostat in its place. Gently insert it into the coupling. It easily engages and does not fall out afterward. The fixation is secure. Now we connect the power wires to it. Tighten the contacts well. It is also necessary to set the desired temperature. I set it to the center, which is approximately 50 degrees Celsius. Now we simply connect the contacts of the indicator light to the thermostat. 1, 2. And we can proceed to install the decorative cover in its place. Gently insert the connector and tighten. Now we just need to connect the mounting screw here, just a little bit.
Checking the operation of the boiler.
The light bulb has lit up. Now we just need to wait for the temperature to rise to 50 degrees and ensure the boiler is functioning properly. Literally, half an hour has passed and the water temperature has started to rise. This means everything is working.